Hi and good morning. Today is going to be another non-technical video because I just got this link to an article from the Irish Times, and I just couldn't resist because I don't think there's a single grain of truth in this article, so I'm just going to go over it and tell you what I think. So, petrol and diesel cars are part of the solution to reduce emissions. And the government should encourage people to buy newer, more environmentally friendly models and just not electric vehicles, an industry figure said. So who is the industry figure? Well, it's Audi Cork General Manager Liam Murphy. Ah, surprise! Audi wants to sell ICE cars till 2030, so now they need to motivate you to do so. Yeah, and it's the same wording pretty much that Herbert Diess used 3 years ago or 2 years ago. He has radically changed his opinion on that. He would not be saying this bullshit anymore. The modern petrol and diesel car is part of the solution. The modern petrol and diesel car. I mean, there's not been much change. There's not much potential in a technology that's like 130 years old in terms of efficiency, not much to get out of it. So, yeah, modern petrol. Yeah, and it goes on with the usual stuff. The newest diesel engines emit lot less emissions than even a diesel engine from 5 years ago. No. CO2 is going to be the same. Maybe there's a bit less nitrous oxide compared to the scandal diesels from 5 years ago. Well, of course. But apart from that, no, it's not going to help the environment. Yeah, so I'm not even gonna go over the rest of the article. There was one statement: factories don't have the capacity at the moment to supply the amount of EVs that the government are calling for. Of course they do. I mean, maybe Audi factories don't have the capacity, but worldwide there's gonna be more than enough. Yes, so if you're worried about your emissions, rule number one: do not bring a new petrol or diesel car onto the road, because it's going to be around for 10, maybe even 20 years and do its pollution. Don't do that. Learn how to drive economically, because then even with your current car, you can cut emissions more than, well, of course, more than with a modern car, because a modern car is just going to be as bad as your old car. Get a smaller car if that's feasible for you, because that's gonna use less petrol, cost you less money, and of course, emit less. And finally, if you do have the money and can afford it, get an electric car and drive around in that. And that's just gonna be as green as your electricity supply. So if you live in Norway, I don't need to tell you, Norwegians, you already found out. It's gonna be green. If you live in Sweden, it's gonna be green. If you live in Germany, it's gonna be like semi-green because you still have stupid coal power plants. If you live in Ireland, I don't know. Oh, let's check. Let's check. Electricity map. Let's find out how green Ireland's electricity is. Like at this very moment, I don't know on average. So Germany, it's 243 grams per kilowatt hour, which is below average. Usually, like on an average over the year, it's more like 390 or something. And Ireland doesn't look too bad either. No, sorry, that's not Ireland. Oh, we don't know. No live data from Ireland. Yeah. Oh, you gotta find out. Sorry. Yes, thanks for listening to my rant about this stupid article. I will link in a comparison between a Golf from 2000 and a Golf from 2015, which shows that surely diesel engines have not gone down in fuel consumption and thus not in emissions in the last 15 years. Yeah, and it's a kind of more factual video than this one, which is really just a rant, because I put in actual numbers that you can find. And you can repeat my calculations for your car and See how it goes. Yeah, thanks for listening in so far. That's it for today. Bye bye.